You are all fine and staying at home. Please stay at home and be safe. Dear girls, today I will going to discuss on an assignment of an English second paper. Here is the assignment. Please look at the screen and you will find the assignment, and I will discuss on the points given in this particular assignment. This is an assignment of English second paper, assignment number 2. Write a paragraph on juvenile delinquency. What does juvenile delinquency mean? Have you any idea about juvenile delinquency? বাংলাতে আমরা বলি কিশোর অপরাধ। কিশোর অপরাধের উপরে একটা প্যারাগ্রাফ তোমাদের লিখতে হবে। In recent time, there have been cases of juvenile delinquency in Bangladesh. Adolescent crime or juvenile crime is on the rise alarmingly. So, hence you are given an assignment to discuss juvenile delinquency, because we all are worried about this matter. First of all, you have to concentrate on topic and learning outcome. Learners will be able to write about two different types of learning patterns. First, we'll be able to use contrasting sentence connectors and cohesive device. Use of reference of personal experiences. Make correct and proper use of prepositions. And some questions are given here to write a paragraph. And here are the instructions or steps. Write within 150 words. Your paragraph should include following points. Number one, what juvenile delinquency is, how teenagers are being involved, how are the personal and social life being affected, suggest the ways to coming out of the crisis. Then you have to follow the structure of the paragraph. Firstly, topic sentence. Secondly, development of ideas. And finally, concluding sentence. Dear students, I will just guide you to write the paragraph. I'm not going to give you a sample writing a paragraph myself. I am helping you. You yourself must write the paragraph. So, I think I should give you some ideas about contrasting sentence connectors. Here are some examples. Example number one, the printed cotton lawn pants have contrasting printed piping. Example number two, in fact, his eyes were almost playful now, contrasting against the seriousness of the previous night. Here, two ideas are given in each sentence, but each sentence has two contrasting points. Contrast means difference, especially when that difference is very noticeable. Contrast often means opposite. So, such sentences must be included in your paragraph. Contrasting sentence connectors. Here are some examples which you can use while writing the paragraph juvenile delinquency. Happy and unhappy family, educated and uneducated family, conscious and unconscious families. These contrasting sentence connectors can be used in the paragraph juvenile delinquency. Then come to another term, cohesive device. This is not a familiar term, but you know the devices. Cohesive devices, sometimes called linking words. These linking words are known to you, familiar to you. You all know about this, but the term is unfamiliar to you. So cohesive devices, sometimes called linking words, linkers, connectors. Cohesive devices are words or phrases that show the relationship between paragraphs or selection of a text or speech. Cohesive devices are words like, for example, in conclusion, however, moreover. So dear girls, I hope you can understand now what are the cohesive devices. Then there is another point you must follow in writing the paragraph, that is proper use of preposition. Please be conscious while you will use the preposition. Put the correct preposition in the correct places. Then there is another instruction for you. Your paragraph must be confined to more or less 150 words. More or less, because it can exceed 150 words, or it can have less than 150 words. But you have to keep in mind that 150 words would be the best. The following points must be mentioned in the paragraph. We will touch these answers of these questions while we will rewrite the paragraph. Dear students, the questions are given you to write a paragraph. You have to write a single paragraph. All the answers must be included in one and single paragraph. Don't divide the paragraph in two or three passages. Don't divide a paragraph into two or three paragraphs. Keep in mind and be aware of the fact that there will be a single paragraph and all the answer must be included in that single paragraph. Don't divide in different parts. Don't write the answers in different parts. All the answers of these questions you have to include in one single paragraph. It will be a continuous paragraph, no gap, no part, no division. Please keep it in mind, because it is very important. If you write a paragraph and divide it into two or three parts, then you will get a zero. No number will be given to you. It will be a single paragraph. So now, how to organize the paragraph? This is also given in your question paper. A paragraph is organized in the following way. topic sentence, development of ideas, and concluding sentence. Now come to the questions. We are now going to discuss the main theme of the paragraph. What juvenile delinquency is? Juvenile delinquency, also known as juvenile offending, in the act of participating in unlawful behavior and activities. A juvenile is a teenager under the age of 18 who breaks state law by committing crimes. Juvenile crimes can range from underage smoking or drinking to property crimes and violent crimes. Dear students, in recent days, there are several incidents you can find in the newspapers or in the media. Each and every day, we find cases and the incidents of juvenile delinquency. So, first of all, you have to know what is juvenile delinquency. So, here is an idea about juvenile delinquency. Juvenile delinquency, also known as juvenile offending, অপরাধ. তার বয়স অনুযায়ী সে যে অপরাধ করছে এবং অপরাধে অংশগ্রহণ করছে এটি হচ্ছে juvenile delinquency. A juvenile is a teenager, kishor, under the age of 18. Kishor kishori under the age of 18. Who breaks state law by committing crimes. আর কি ধরনের অপরাধ সে করছে? Underage smoking, drinking, to property crimes and violent crimes, and even they also sometimes involved in killing. How teenagers are being involved? This is a very important point. Why and how these teenagers, the adolescents and the juveniles, are engaged in such crimes? There are several causes behind a teenager's involvement in juvenile delinquency, like lack of communication with parents of family or family members, lack of social and moral training, broken or disturbed families, surrounding environment and company, and technology, that is internet and social media, lack of attachment with the family, parents, and this causes the mental disturbance among the teenagers. Lack of attachment, indisciplined lifestyle, all these are responsible for this, such kinds of crimes. And here is another point: excessive use of internet. The juvenile or adolescent population is greatly influenced by the internet. Crime films, violent films are available in internet, and that is a threat to child psychology and also in mental development. Various means of entertainment sometimes put the children into dilemma because of the differences in cultural values. And irresponsibility of law enforcement agencies is another reason. The social role of the police is noticeably absent. They act very indifferent towards their responsibility to the children and their rights. There is another cause, that is the easy access to drugs. The increasing number of drug addicted children is on a high peak. Some out of just curiosity, and others are addicted because of the easy access of drugs. Children who are drug addicted can't develop a strong personality, and they involve in different types of crimes to get the money for their drug addiction. So, dear girls, these are the reasons for a teenager's involvement in juvenile delinquency. How are the personal and social life being affected? The personal or social life are being affected in the following way. When a child or a teenager is drug addicted, is involved in crimes, and is out of his study, what happens to the family? Hampering peace and happiness in family. Disturbs normal mental growth of that teenager or the child. Hampering study. And the child feels neglected and hated by family and community. Also feeling unwanted. Suggestion to come out of this crisis. The suggestions are, how can we prevent our children, our teenagers from committing crimes? How can they live a healthy life, mentally and physically healthy, and continues his studies and going to be a good citizen of his country? The suggestions are care of family and parents, providing proper education, involving in sports and recreation, parent-children interaction, moral and religious education, development of teacher-student relation. So these are the suggestions to come out of this crisis. If a teenager or a child gets proper care of the family members and obviously from his parents, he can be a good son or girl for his family. Providing proper education, involving in sports and recreation. In spite of using internet and using time in social medias, if a girl or son can be engaged in sports and recreation activities, this will be good for that family. Parent-children interaction. Today, the parents remain busy for their profession. So the teenagers, all the children remain at home and they feel lonely. So parent-children interaction must be developed. Parents should give much more time for their children. And here are the responsibility both in his family, both of for his family and the school, that is moral and religious education. The students should be given moral and religious education both in the family and the educational institution. And development of teacher-student relationship. If the teachers are concerned about their students, not only in the class, but also out of class, that will give us a hope that the students will be safe and be a good citizen for our country. So these are the guideline to write a paragraph on juvenile delinquency. Dear students, following my instructions and guidelines, I hope now you can write a good paragraph on juvenile delinquency. Please confine the paragraph in 150 words and write a continuous single paragraph. No gap, no division in this paragraph. Hope you will do it better. So goodbye for today. Stay at home, stay safe.